Hi everybody. Got another interesting test. This is the OV-10 Bronco, made by Rockwell. It's a 60s aircraft, used in Vietnam a lot, and it is still currently in service with the Philippines Air Force, I believe. But they will be retiring theirs in 2024. The US Air Force, I think they discontinued it in 1995, although it was brought back for a very short stint in 2014, I think it was, when they used it in the East Mediterranean, around Syria. I think that was in support of special forces. So it's a nicely modelled one. The cockpit looks really good. We'll compare it to the real thing in a sec. Let's have a look outside. Very nicely done. I especially like the this little bit of wear there. That looks quite good. So this is in the Thai Air Force marking, sort of, I guess. I mean, it doesn't look very... The handle's a bit small, I guess, but it's got a flag on it, so... And that's interesting. The elevator stops going down when you're about two thirds of the way through your throttle of the joystick. No idea why. The upwards movement is in line. That's full joystick back, and then it's fine. But going down, that stops, and then that's full joystick forwards now. I've no idea what those little shark fins are. So let's have a look around the cockpit. And let's compare it to a real one. And yeah, it's got the main features completely correct, hasn't it? So yeah, that's 9 out of 10 for the cockpit, that's for sure. So let's see what works and what doesn't. That doesn't appear to be doing anything, even though it appears that it should do something. Maybe that's the brake. Wow, even the fuel emergency to shut off seems to be working. Well, that's pretty good, yeah. So, still 9 out of 10. It is an amazing view out of the cockpit. It's more like being in a helicopter. Okay, so let's get some power on. Looks like the fuel's automatically set to on, as far as I can see. Is that the canopy release? Nope, we don't know what that is, so we'll just leave it, just in case. Ah, that's the canopy release, okay. That's marvellous. So, just a bit of information. This is the Rockwell OV-10 Bronco. The model is made by ariebaba. A-R-I-E-Baba. And this is version 1.0.2, which was released on the 9th of October 2023. So this aircraft is actually a year younger than I am, so yeah, and it's still in service and so am I, that's great. So battery's on, everything seems to be working, it should be working apart from the HUD and stuff, which is a bit strange, I guess that should be on. Ah, the switches are reversed, aren't they? Yeah, so the the throttle control seems to be at flight idle and not at ground start for some reason. But you have to, if you push the thrust reverse button, that goes straight to ground start. So I'm just holding it there for now while it starts up. I guess it started. Yeah, so it's opposite to the arrows. If you want to go up, you have to scroll back on the wheel, which is a bit strange. What does this on do? Is that the wiper on? Must be the wiper on. So we got lights, they're all fine. To check flap. So the real aircraft's got a top speed of 250 knots, and we'll see how we do. That red line's at 350, which is, you know, going to be your wings are falling off, but we'll see how we get on. So we're flying from Changi, which is in southern Thailand, which is just down the bottom of the peninsula, very near to Singapore. Oh, the radio's off, is it? Okay. Yeah, so it looks like we can't speak to the tower, which is very annoying. Okay, we'll do it solo. Unless I've missed it somewhere. Let's have a third quick check. Is that a coffee cup stain? I mean, come on. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we're having a radio. Seems to have an ADF though, which is a bit bizarre. But I can't change the frequency on the VHF, so I guess we've got no comms. So we'll be going on our own then. Well, this is a bit embarrassing. We can't take the handbrake off. I so very rarely use the keyboard controls. I've got no idea where that is. Okay, I'm going to go and check on the website, see if there's any information on there.
A few moments later.
So there is a manual that comes with this aircraft. Unfortunately, it's not very good. It just seems to be a set of checklists. And a bit of that info. Whatever position that's in. Parking brake is not releasing. Let's try going backwards. Okay, so that worked. Going into slew mode and then slewing it forwards and backwards seems to have released the brake, which is great. So now we can go fly. Bear in mind I'm having to keep my finger on the thrust reverse button because I think if I let go it'll just accelerate. Oh no, we're okay, cool. So she trims pretty well. There was a thing there saying of it's a reverse trim, so... I mean, I'm using mine on the joystick and it's the same, it's the normal way it should be. I'm just going it full beans to see how fast we go. Just about reaching 180, so with a bit of prop. So I guess we should try and land. She does look very good in the air as well. Very nice. Set flaps of 2 and gear down. You wouldn't want to live in any of those high rises, would you? Jeez. Reverse thrust works very well. So it flies a bit strangely. But it is a turboprop used for very low speeds, and low speed turboprops are always a bit of a nightmare to fly. So I'm going to give that an 8 out of 10. It's brilliant. What is she doing? If that is a she. So, 8 out of 10, ariebaba, 1.02, released on the 9th of October. Great little model, nice aircraft, loving it. Although I would prefer something a bit more speedy for the returns of using two engines that have got jets in them. Anyway, yeah, that's a good little one.